Hi friends, I am Dr. Shivani Bhatt and today I would like to share with you small tips on how and when liquid EDTA and gel EDTA is to be used in root canal procedures. Basically, there are two types of EDTAs that are available in the market. The first is in the form of a gel. So I have been using EvuPrep since I am doing root canal procedures. It works for me well. And the second type that is available in the market is in the form of a liquid. I have been using EvuPrep Plus, which is liquid. So EvuPrep is a gel and EvuPrep Plus is a liquid. Both are manufactured by Dental Avenue company. So I have been using both of them with good results. I would like to highlight a few points on how and when to be used these two for an efficient root canal treatment. So whenever there is a tooth in which once you open the pulp chamber and it starts bleeding, which means the pulp is alive, it is recommended to fill the pulp chamber with EvuPrep or the gel EDTA before using sodium hypochlorite. The scientific reason behind it is that when you fill the pulp chamber with gel EDTA, it helps degenerate the pulp very well and remove all the pulp very easily from the chamber, even if it is bleeding and even if the site is blocked. It helps to clean the chamber better. But if you use sodium hypochlorite instead of using a gel EDTA in the initial part, as soon as you open the pulp chamber, the blood that is formed in the chamber gets clotted, it becomes black and it blocks the canals, and it is difficult for us to again negotiate it. So always use gel before using sodium hypochlorite as soon as you open the pulp chamber and if the pulp is alive, if there is bleeding from the chamber. If you are addressing a non-vital tooth, then whenever you feel that there is lot of debris accumulated inside the canal, or the canal is curved, it is narrow, because most of the times in non-vital teeth, more often you see narrow canals. So if you feel there's a narrow canal, the canal is curved, always coat the instrument that is going inside the canal with a gel EDTA. If there is presence of pulp stone in the chamber, fill the chamber with gel EDTA, wait for 5 minutes and then remove the stone. So these are a few uses of gel EDTA. Now we come to liquid EDTA. So basically liquid EDTA mainly helps to remove the smear layer from the canal. So before obturation, it is recommended that using gel EDTA liquid EDTA less than 1 minute inside the canal and with agitation will help remove the smear layer, which will make the obturation more clean and better and make the sealer go inside the difficult anomalies of the canal. So yes, and one more thing, if there is any blockage or any ledge formation inside the narrow root, again you can use the same liquid EDTA. Fill the canals and the chamber with liquid EDTA and you can start negotiating with the help of your hand files. I will try to post more clinical videos on the usage of both. Thank you so much.